I would request my very senior Professor Masood Hameed Saab, whom I respect and whom I have observed that he's one of the very few truly visionary healthcare providers in Pakistan. Since the day he started the Dow University as the Vice Chancellor, and I was lucky enough to be invited by him to assist him in some ways, which I did, alhamdulillah. And I think that we are blessed to have people like Dr. Masood Saab in the helm of affairs. So I would request you, sir, to say a few words and encourage us.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Honorable delegates, I am really honored to be here at the inauguration of this conference, which is regarding quality health care. And I must congratulate the organizers, especially Dr. Zaki and Dr. Khurshid, for giving us this opportunity to share with this August gathering a very important issue, and that is of quality health care. I would like to mention two things. One is, when we talk about quality health care, we have to think about preventive health care also. So that is something which we all need to stress upon and which we all need to work. And when we talk about preventive health care, it is a vast subject, and it's going to reduce the burden of diseases. Like you know, the burden of hepatitis B and C in Pakistan, diabetes, hypertension, psychiatric illnesses, joint diseases is too much. And no country on earth can manage with whatever resources they have a huge burden of disease. So we have to stress on to the primary preventive strategies. Second thing which I want to mention is that the word which is healthcare industry is the one which is bothering all of us. Because when you move from a missionary statement or a missionary zeal and you take it to the level of industry, then everything becomes a business. Healthcare is not a business. It is a mission. And if we teach our students, our healthcare providers, that it is a mission, then the quality would come in. But if it is a business, then the business would come in, as we are seeing today. I would further take up the point of Dr. Murad, because he was very soft on the issue of ethical side, that what we are seeing in our practice is a very aggressive marketing. Very aggressive marketing by a pharmaceutical has led to unethical practices and prescription, which we see day in and day out in the form of, say, I'll give example of one thing, and that is omeprazole compound, 40 milligrams twice a day. Keep on seeing these types of prescriptions by so many doctors day in and day out. What is this happening in our society? Now, this is aggressive marketing. Similar is the marketing by our friends from laboratories. I mean, this is, Dr. Sarmad has mentioned about his experience for the last 25 years. Maybe for the same time, I am also practicing in this city. We have seen different era of practice. We have seen Professor Mushtaq Hasan also practicing and providing quality health care. We have seen Colonel Najib also, Malik Ali Sheikh, and so on and so forth. And now we are seeing the younger generation. It has moved into business. Now people are asking for the share. And when you talk about share, then you don't see right and left. You just see straight on to what is the share out of this business. I will not take much of the time. There are a lot many things to be talked about heart to heart, but I am not afraid of. It is our duty to train the human resource according to the values. As policymakers, I would like to request all of you to please stress on to the training aspect in whichever position you are, either at the helm of affairs of pharmaceutical industry, your representatives, your management should learn that what is the dynamic and the system is that as doctor, I have to prescribe medicine. I have to prescribe medicine for my patient. No need to worry about if I am not going to prescribe this medicine, I'll prescribe that, this, I'll do this. I'll have to prescribe test also. So why are you worried? Why are you running after doctors to give you more business? He will do his job. You will get the share. So starting from pharmaceutical to medical profession, to allied health workers, to the medical technologist, we are seeing a deterioration in our values. Though we are on one hand talking about, yes, improvement in the healthcare in the form of high tech, but at times that high tech also is coming the other way around. But there are so many things which we can talk about, but I think my request to all the stakeholders that when, whichever position you are, please try to bring in iman, honesty in the people, and automatically everything will come in. Money will follow if you perform your duties with honesty. Last thing is I want to mention is about Pakistan Day. So we are all celebrating Pakistan Day. I would like to mention, and we all know, that what we are today, we are because of Pakistan. I'll just quote the example of a medical graduate who is standing in front of you, that is myself. I studied medicine in this country and I paid 144 rupees for 1 year tuition fee. For 1 year tuition fee, this was 12 rupees per month in 1971 and 72. And what we are charging in public sector universities nowadays also is only 20,000 rupees per year as tuition fee for a medical degree. Which is the country on earth which will provide you this type of education? This is Pakistan. Full of human resource, full of sacrifices this country is giving for the people, but what we are doing, what we are giving to this country. So my request is that please do, in whichever position you are, try to do something good to this country. Each and every step, think, is it for the betterment of this country, or my this action would cause harm to this country? Make this bottom line, and from here if you start working, and we all, there are so many people are working on this note, but if all of us start working and thinking like this, I think there is no power on earth that can look down on Pakistan because of its so many potential inherent capabilities. And I'll just like to share two or three. We have the largest, a very large coastal line. We have minerals. We have the atomic power. We have sixth largest army in the world. And above all, we have a very, very strong nation, which is very durable nation. And this we have seen in so many crises. We have just seen the crisis of our floods. The way we are working, the way our doctors are working, under the worst circumstances, bad circumstances, we are giving the results. So with this note, I would like to end and say that please think about Pakistan. Don't ever try to undermine yourself. Don't get depressed. There is no point in depressing. We are a nation, and you know the nation is a very strong nation. With this, I am really grateful to all of you for a very patient hearing. Thank you.